What's up, guys? Dan the Yankees fan is back with some more MLB 16 Yankees franchise mode, and today we're going to be taking on the Boston Red Sox from the Bronx as Michael Pineda, who's been outstanding so far this season with a 2.22 ERA, will go up against Elias. Yeah, I've hit against him before, and I still can't say his name. So, take a quick recap of how the team's doing so far. I mean, bullpen's doing pretty good. Expect a little bit more out of Batances and Chapman, but Miller's been beasting. Middle of the bullpen, very quality. Chris Sale, he started off the year slow, but he's going to be beast. Kluber's been great. Tanaka's been excellent. Pineda's been amazing. Henderson's been okay. He's starting to slow down a little bit. Lineup, as you see there, no one really struggling that much except for Greg Bird, who we're going to, I mean, you know, Soler's been pretty slow to start things off. Castro. Right now, we have Gary Sanchez still riding the bench. Greg Bird is going to start today because I want to give him some at-bats to try and improve his average. But, you know, it's starting to get to the point where do we trade Bird? I mean, if I trade him, I mean, he's got some potential. And there was also this trade I was looking at. What was it? It was Henderson and Cervelli, yeah, I remember now. Alright, it was Henderson and Cervelli to get, like, and some other guy to get, like, Orderizzi. Let me know if you think I should do this trade. This is basically me saying that I'm ready to move on from Francisco Cervelli and start to play, Greg Bird or Gary Sanchez instead. He's been really good to start the season, but of course I'd also have to go up the top 50 prospects. So that trade I'm not sure about yet. We'll see. So let's get into today's game. Throwback old. Yeah. We'll wear alternate jerseys today. They're saying the, yeah, the Red Sox world. I'm not wearing those dumb jerseys. Those are weird. So Pineda on the hill today. He's been great so far this year. We're only a half game back out of the division, so looking for a win today. I guess the lefty want more righty bats in the lineup. This is where I do debate starting Gary Sanchez, and I think I'm going to. And I'm gonna sit. First of all, Greg Bird doesn't play third. Yeah, I'm gonna play him for him. DH, and then we'll put you behind the plate. So once again, I'm not gonna start. You know what? I want to start Greg Bird. I don't give him a lot of starts. This isn't the time to play him. So we're gonna hold off on starting Bird for today's game. Belanger has been amazing to start off the season. We're gonna lead him off. We're about to kick him a second. No, we're gonna lead off. We're gonna lead off Gardner, and then we're gonna back kick him a second. Hanley third. Gary fourth. No, it's Soler fourth. Gary fifth. Castro sixth. Blackman seventh. Cervelli eighth, and Belanger ninth. Tell me to replace Soler. Well, here's what I can do. Put Hanley in right, or we'll put him in left and Gardner in right. And then put in Bird for Soler. And Soler has been horrible, too. I mean, he hasn't been, like, horrible, but he's been pretty horrible. So we're going to hit Bird for, see if we can get him to pick up his numbers. Hitting in the middle of the order. Let's do it. Ryan Elias has been pretty poor this year at 4.64 ERA, but Pineda has been above expected. He's exceeding expectations. That's what we'll say. Pineda's been amazing. We'll look for another quality start today against Boston, who is struggling at 22-27. Let's see the team rankings for least amount of home runs allowed. So, today's ball game from Yankee Stadium.
Afternoon baseball now, and a fine Sunday for our national pastime from Yankee Stadium in the Bronx. Today, the finale of this three-game weekend series between the Boston Red Sox and the New York Yankees. It's baseball on the show, and it's coming up next.
27-time world champions, we were unable to advance.
Michael Pineda.
Playoff round last year. Pineda will start today 4-4 with a 2.22 ERA in 9 games, 65
well, guys,
innings, 15 only 54 hits,
nice
11 walks.
So far. You look at that ERA.
He has been amazing
in the low
this year.
Twos.
I don't know, maybe even Cy Young potential. I haven't really checked, but Pineda looking good so far.
Jackie Bradley Jr.
JBJ
lead off. His way to the plate,
he's 0-7
in the
series
at
2 strikeouts. So he struggled against the Yankees here in the series. We'll look to turn things around today. The first pitch is in there for strike one.
Sunday finale. The first pitch today is taken for strike one. You know, this Yankee ball club entering play this afternoon here, EK. They've been playing some pretty good baseball. 5-2 over the last seven.
And they just put away pitch to JBJ. It's crushed to right field. Way back. See ya. A leadoff home run for JBJ. Pineda hung that slider right in there. And
a solo
Jackie Bradley
shot
made
off the bat of Jackie
right away
Bradley Jr.
Really
seven home runs
Here's
for him
Hudson.
On the
That's
year now. And
Bradley's
the Red Sox get the
year.
Game's first run. It's 1-0.
Steven
Hudson will take his first cuts now. And after the
Men's
leadoff home run to start the ballgame, does the game plan
minutes.
Change it all from
Go
a pitching perspective?
Medal.
Well, I think it's Deal a little bit more of a shock to the system.
Can he not hang the slider this time?
You're just not expecting that leadoff guy to be the guy that takes
pitch from Pineda to Hudson.
Nope.
Down and away, it's a ball and two strikes.
A classic strikeout pitch there on
1-2
0-2.
From Pineda.
It's one he loves going to, but great recognition there at the plate to lay off.
Bases are empty here, nobody out.
1-2. Is
another late
foul.
Making contact
Make
on that
Pineda
swing, and
early.
We'll do it again on 1-2.
Patances is really tired. We'll probably use Miller and Chapman today and see if we can get 7 quality.
Pineda gets the sign. Looking to put him away here on a ball and two
strikes. Oh, nice slider. That
and
one
a good
was
bite
not
to that
the hanger
that JBJ
hit out of the park.
Swings through it for the first out of the inning.
Beauty.
With that, here's
Hudson
a look at John Farrell's Boston Red Sox.
Red Sox,
Eric, who should
JBJ
we keep an eye
off?
On?
Steven Hudson,
well, guys,
second best, third, Shaw, fourth, Santana, fifth, Pedro, sixth, Swihart, seventh,
sports a batting average with runners in scoring position over 300, so
ninth,
you could say
obviously
he relishes
this,
in those big moments.
Lot
we'll see if that's the case in this one. Mookie Betts
offense taking a hit. Ortiz retired last year.
Take a look at the splits there. He's actually a better hitter against right-handed pitching this season. And a fastball's in there for strike one. Swing,
gap,
line, drive. That's going to be trouble.
Switch.
Betts is going to turn for second.
He's heading for second, and he'll be in there with a stand-up
and
double.
And he'll cruise into the bag at second with
so
a one-out double.
So rough inning for Pineda here in the first. Here's
Travis Shaw. Will stand
much better
in now, and as you can easily tell from the splits, he's really
first
struggled
pitch.
Away from home. Broken,
broken
bat as this ball's hit on the ground.
Back to Pineda to first. He's got to be quick,
so
and he's safe.
At him at first,
an infield broken
single,
bat base hit for Travis Shaw.
Third now.
Here's Carlos Santana, a lot better
Santana
on the road.
Will stand in, and as you can see, the numbers
then on the corners, one out for the Sox. First
he's
pitch.
Been much better once he gets out on the road. Sends that one out of play for strike
looking
one.
Looking for a double play.
The 0-1 pitch.
The 0-1.
In there, and it's 0-2 now.
Now we're going to go for
strike. First inning's been
a
rough one already. He needs an out here in the worst way.
Boy.
And you don't want to get caught having to play catch-up this early in the ballgame.
Yeah, we already have to play catch-up. We're down 1-0
in the first. He's got to work his way out of this jam right now.
1-2.
Smoke toward the
hit.
Hole. And that is into right field. A base hit.
This is not going well.
Third crosses the plate. It's
all right,
a
2-0
ball game.
In first inning. Here's Justin Pedroia.
Dustin Pedroia will dig in, and this season certainly hasn't been all that
rough
kind to him
Pedroia.
As he
that was a broken
play
bat,
with the average down in the 230s.
That ball was so deep in his kitchen, that was the only thing he could do was foul it off,
Deal
break
one.
His bat, and hope to get a
low
better
and
pitch
inside.
On the next one.
And a change up here, but that's taken low in the
20th pitch.
Ball.
He's only recorded one out. The runners go. What's Gary
not
doing? He's safe. Are you kidding me? Oh, my gosh. Double steal works. The 1-2. He swung on a miss.
And it'll probably take a base hit now to get that runner across from third. Now that we have a chance, let's give you a look at the Yankees defense. It's brought to us by Majestic. Eric?
Well, guys, this manager loves to do the defensive shifts. So we're going to see a lot of odd formations as the game goes along. I can't wait to see how it works.
1-1 for Pineda is fouled off, and now he can get out of the thing.
He had to hit the deck for dear life that time. Already 24 pitches to this point in the inning.
Score, that's inside.
In tight with the slider, 2-2.
And that's the right spot
for
that
pitch. Can Pineda get out of it? Yes, he can. Strike three. He strikes out three in the inning, but gives up two runs, including a home run for Jack Bradley. Four hits.
No errors and a couple of men left on.
Yankees already got some pitches to do.
Elias
for the Red Sox pitches 4.6 for
him.
9 games, 64 and a third innings pitch.
Yeah, Maddie,
61 hits, more than a hit per inning. 27 walks, 46 strikeouts, not a great ratio.
Only allowed two
Gardner
runs.
Will lead off against him. The series is 2-9 with two bases. He's batting 295 on the season. A hot start for Gardner. Look to, you know, continue his hot start. And produce
and this
more
one's not close.
In
it's
his,
in the dirt for ball one.
Now,
these Red Sox entering play here this afternoon, EK. They came out on the losing end last time out and are in a bit of a skid. Ooh. In fact, they've lost seven of their last ten.
How's the pitch in the dirt?
That includes losses in the first two games of this series, so they just need to have something positive.
Yanks go for the sweep
way.
Today.
Salvaging the finale
the
might just be the thing.
Off on Gardner. Of course, it's going to be tough. They're already down 2-0 early in this game.
Set to deal on a ball and two strikes.
From Urias to Gardner.
They really punch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
He strikes out, and here's Jason Kipnis. A great start of season by 308 with 10 homers.
Getting the start here despite being out of the lineup last night.
That's a 308, not 310.
Into the windup and
first pitch to Kipnis.
And he catches the inside corner for a called strike. Nothing in one.
That's such a good pitch to get ahead. Lefty on lefty. It's a big looping curveball.
Oh, that curve
makes it very difficult
in the left,
for the hitter to try and time what's coming next.
Plays made for the
Bradley
quick second out.
Is in his tracks now
stepping
as he
in
makes the
former
catch
Red Sox
for out
Hanley
number two.
Ramirez.
Hanley Ramirez will stand
struggling
in
so far this year.
There it is.
Average down
between
to
242. April and May.
Former Boston Red Sox picked up on waivers last year by the Yankees.
Into the seats,
0-1. That was fouled off 0-1.
Here comes the 0-1.
Here's the 0-1 pitch.
On a good curveball. Came back to catch the strike zone there, and it's 0-2.
And you kind of get the sense that he's not really messing around out there too much.
Pitch, Urias,
there hasn't been a whole lot of setting guys up here in this inning. He's just
yeah, last
to get
game
that
we played, we beat the Astros
by
final score 1-0. We've already given
ready
up 2-0
on
zero
one and
first.
Two.
1-2 pitch.
The
swinging ball on a bad pitch. You got to beat it. You got to beat it. You got to get there. You can get there.
Plenty of time.
Yankees go down in order at the end of one. Red Sox lead.
No hits, no errors, and no one left.
Leading up the Sox to Sandoval. Pretty decent numbers to start off here.
He'll get us started here in the top of the second.
First pitch for Pineda, 26 pitches. Tied the side in the first, and that is crushed in the right. Watch it go. See ya.
And it's
one pitch in the second inning, and that one's gone. Pineda has not impressed so far in his start.
A solo shot here for Pablo Sandoval as the Red Sox have moved out 3-0. Chris Young is at the plate as he looks at ball one.
Chris Young will step in, former Yankee.
Sneaks a fastball by him at the letters. It's 1-1.
Yeah, kind of a late decision to swing there. Even if he hits that thing, that might just be a routine fly to right.
1-2 from Pineda to Young.
And he reaches for one out
four
of his
strikeout
own.
That's how he's gotten all this
for the first out.
Boy, he doesn't get a strikeout.
Jackie Bradley Jr.
Here's JBJ leadoff home run. Start this
remember,
game.
He led off the ball game with that home run to get this offense
grand
going.
Third.
Hit to third. Throw gets
and
him.
Play
two down.
First out. Two outs here, Steven Hudson. He struck
Steven
out.
Hudson. He looked to bounce back Hudson. After striking out his last time
first
up.
Pitch.
Well, at the very least, he went down hacking.
And strike
striking
one.
Out is one of the many frustrations that go along with hitting, and you have to accept that it's going to happen
one.
Sometimes.
In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Pineda's ready. Here
and
it is on 0-2.
From Pineda to Hudson.
Swung
on
and
missed
and
a slider
in
the dirt.
In the dirt.
Gary over to first, and the inning is over.
Ends the inning.
He has given up three runs there too, but also five strikeouts. Pineda, we've seen a lot of good and a lot of bad. Headed to the bottom of the second. We'll go to the bottom of the second. Down three.
Greg Bird.
Greg Bird leading up, lead off during his five-game hit streak, batting 261. So he struggled so far to start the year, batting average only at 192. But you know, showing some signs of improving.
A little tardy there. No balls and
a
strike.
Fastball for
well, you got to figure that this guy's going to come out here free and easy here in the second. He's got a three-run cushion already. No reason not to come right
out. To the left, but it's
now
gonna
a ball
go
hit in the air, but in play perhaps down the line, and they can't run it down. The windup and the 0-2 pitch.
From Urias to Bird.
Chop foul at the plate, and we'll do it again.
The 0-2.
The next 0-2 misses, and that'll move it to 1-2 now.
Could be that that high fastball there was just a setup pitch. Now you've kind of established that high sight level. Could be a good time to break
off,
off
but
a
at least
nasty curveball.
Oh, I guess that was a good swing. I probably did hit the strike zone. The 1-2.
The 1-2 pitch. And
that
they'll try to get him fishing
Bird
there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2.
And you know, this is what the good ones do. They can wait you out up there. They sort of foul pitches off
and
take pitches. They make the pitcher
and
come
pops
to
it
you.
Up shallow left center.
Backs up a bit and he takes charge
plays
for the
first
out.
Batting fifth is Gary Sanchez. In the series, 3-for-6
in
an RBI batting. 297 on
the
season. The
win last night as he
and the way he's looking, it's about time that we trade Francisco Cerulli.
So
of course, we've got to give him more time. I'm going to ride Gary Sanchez.
Good one yesterday.
Probably gonna ride him on the bench for the rest of the season, and if he'll get at bats, he'll definitely get at bats. If he continues to play well, we will trade Francisco Cerulli or
one ball and one strike.
Well, I don't know. We'll have to see because I gotta see if he's a free agent or not. 1-1 to Gary, the 20th pitch.
Lifted in the air
in the shallow left.
Bradley is there.
Bradley under it. That's
makes the play, and there are two gone now.
You got enough Castro. We'll start the season only batting 240.
We'll get his first opportunity here. Took an 0-for-4 in the victory last night.
0-for-4 in the last night's win against Boston. The first pitch. And shallow right center. That might bloop in there. Nope, it won't. Plays made. Yankees got an order, and they off to a slow start. 3-0.
Still down 3-0.
Leading off for
the
Sox.
Most famous urban park in the United States, Central Park, set to go again here from Yankee Stadium.
Leading off with Mookie Betts, he scored.
Mookie Betts
off of a double
is into the box as we are all set to begin the third. Hot shot.
Ground
to short.
Belanger.
Belanger is
young
start
for the Yanks. I'll make the play just in time. Well, you got to hurry up.
To start the third.
Travis Shaw, a single.
Shaw steps into the box. Pineda sets his sights. Here comes the first pitch. That's yanked into the stands. Strike one.
Here's the 0-1 from Pineda.
Off-speed pitch in the dirt, as he takes it for a ball.
1-1.
Fastball
called
strike.
Fastball right down
one
the middle. Take
two.
It for strike two.
And you kind of wonder if he's learned anything
the
out there.
40th pitch.
There's another pitch.
Swung
right
on and missed
a
6K
I think he's lucky
for Pineda.
That
I mean, he's given up already five hits
now
this game.
Now a swing and a miss here
as he's
down on strike.
He's either giving up a hit
so
or striking out the batter.
Down
here's
to
Santana.
Begin the third. Carlos Santana is in for the second time here as he looks at one outside. It's 1-0.
1-0.
Inside corner, a ball and a strike.
And this would be a good bounce back inning for him. He's looked a little shaky here
up
in these
middle.
First few innings.
Belanger,
so
can he make the throw in time? No, he can't. It's an infield base hit for Santana.
So it'll be scored as an infield single.
Almost the 1-2-3 inning for Pineda, but not quite.
Pedroia comes to the plate looking to put
Pedroia.
The ball in
that
play.
Went to left,
went
but
down on strikes last time. Two out with
struck
the man
out
at
his first at bat, the 0-1.
Again to first.
Low,
third
first.
Time.
The 1-1.
And he finds a way to catch the zone here. It's 1-2.
Six strikeout. Pitch.
And a slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at 2-2.
2-2.
Yeah, that's a great pitch on 1-2. Started in the zone, and hopefully you'll get that guy thinking he needs to protect.
Ooh, that was
turned out to be a good take.
This will be the 50th pitch for
Making
Pineda early
sweat
in this game.
Out there, the seventh
Here it
pitch
is.
Coming up. Hit the other
and
way
right.
out toward right
Gardner,
field.
Gardner playing right
Gardner
tonight, makes
the
play.
There.
And
no
inning is over.
Inning
Initial hit for Santana. Other than that,
over.
Pineda looked
One
very impressive. 7-8-9 for
the
Yankees.
But they're on top by a count of 3-0. Charlie Blackman.
Blackman
will lead
it off.
Forward to begin the inning. 7-8-9 to start the home third.
He is an older player on this team, and the Yankees obviously trying to on a younger team. Might be on the trade block.
Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. And he sat down one away.
So one away stepping in is Cervelli. He's out of
Francisco Cervelli will stand in.
They really, if he wasn't playing good,
he would
be traded off the team already. He's on a short leash with...
Tries to catch him napping, but he missed the bunt attempt. Strike one.
Tries the bunt. We're going to try and land on that bunt for our first hit. The 0-1.
Showing bunt, but he winds up taking ball one.
Hold on until we get two strikes.
He wanted to go after that one, but that's a good eye to just watch it all the way in.
Bunt attempt, but that'll bounce
foul. Ball. It's 1-2 now. We're going to have to swing the bat.
Here's the 1-2 delivery.
And the 1-2.
On the
Grounded
ground,
up the middle. Could be a tough play, but he got him. That's
Throw
the second
in time
out.
At first for out number two.
Billy so, Belanger, two away here's Belanger.
Stand in now with
rookie
two away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3
inning. Got
him
off season trade from the Blue Jays. The Blue Jays probably wishing they didn't give this guy up
they haven't been able
first
to
pitch.
Any kind of threat whatsoever.
Back
and
behind
a
the
foul
plate, but he can't
the plate. And no one will get this one.
12-game hitting streak for the rookie, top 50 prospects in the major leagues. The 0-1. Grounded to short.
Short
should be an
Hudson
easy play.
He's
once again at on 1-2-3.
Rice
perfect 2-3.
1-2-3.
And it has not been
Bombers.
Perfect at the end of three.
They trail
Red Sox
this
lead
one,
it
3-0.
3-0.
Blake
Leading off, he's fired. He struck out.
Ready
first.
Here as we begin the top of the fourth.
First pitch.
Blake Swihart. First pitch hack in here,
down.
And that's the first strike.
Here's the 0-1 from Pineda.
That's
low
over, but low. It's a ball and a strike. Cutter misses, and it's 3-1. Check that 2-1.
He just messed up the strike count. 2-1 pitch.
Off speed pitch.
And
good for
two
strike
two.
And
2-2 from Pineda is
swinging
and
a miss
another
on
strike
slider, and that's out number one.
I mean, you know, a swing and miss stuff has been good when he doesn't hang it over the plate. Here's Sandoval. He had a solo.
So the bases are empty with one man gone. And standing in now, the
First
versatile
pitch.
Pablo Sandoval.
Local
He'll
ball.
Start him here with a changeup, but it's taken for ball one.
1-0.
And the fastball hitting 93 on the gun. It's 1-1.
And 1-1. Yankees game today at like 3 o'clock. It would be a 1
and
o'clock game
behind now to
in Anaheim
two.
To look for the sweep in L.A. Just in our video
Pineda into his
sweep
motion.
Against Boston.
1-2
one-two
on
to Sandoval.
And
another strike. I don't know what he was looking at.
And that's
that was a hanging slider. If he would have swung at him,
it
went a long way.
Two strikeouts here to start out the inning, but that's eight for him now in the ball game.
Eight
These
strikeouts for Pineda.
Really
watch
out. Figuring them out.
Well, two outs here, Shaw or Young, Chris Young.
Here's Chris Young.
Like I said before, former Yankee outfielder.
And so watch one miss down
ball.
And
well,
in
only
for
played
a ball,
one season.
1-0.
1-0. Up the middle, a base
on
hit.
On the ground, up the middle. And that
not
finds
get that
its
one, two,
way
three
through
in.
For a base hit.
Gotten one all game. Two outs, here's JBJ. Solo shot
Bradley
first
Jr.
lead off the game.
Strides
first
into
pitch.
The box now.
Oh, look out.
One over the wall back in the opening frame. Now an off-speed pitch well inside, and it forces him to bounce away from danger. And a strike to even the count. 1-1.
1-1.
Foul right at the plate.
Can Pineda get his ninth strike out of the game?
This is pulled into
right,
and that'll get down for a base hit.
I'm seeing Gardner left, but not tonight. He's playing left as Hamlin. So, two back-to-back, two out hits, two outs here, Steven Hudson. He does that 2 Ks.
A punch-out victim twice already. EK, I'll ask you because you're the one sitting next to me. Do you approach an at-bat differently when you have two strikeouts under your belt this early in the game?
Well, you do in the sense that whatever you did the first two times, it wasn't working. But I think if you start worrying too much about trying to avoid the hat trick or worse,
it'll start becoming a mind.
And they're 2-2.
You'll start falling into some pretty bad habits.
Pitch, the 70th for Pineda.
And he's got himself
and he said he went.
He picks up strikeout
I mean, Pineda, he has given up three runs retired. Already and nine hits. See the speedy eight Brett hits for the Sox.
Start things out when we come back.
Strikeouts.
On now to
four.
The bottom half.
The bottom
of
half.
Number
Yankees
four.
Still trail. By three.
Brett Gardner.
Gardner will lead off. He struck out the first lead off the ball game.
With his guys still looking for their first hit of the ball game.
No hits to stay up for the Yanks. First pitch.
Base runner too. Nine up, nine down.
Pulled toward
and
right
shallow
center
right
field.
Center.
Young is there.
And on one pitch. One
he's
out.
Got it one away.
One away. Here's Kipnis. Fly it out in the first.
So the
no hits yet for the Yanks.
Here with one away.
Red Sox already have
now,
eight.
The power hitting second baseman
gets
Jason
the 30th
Kipnis.
Pitch for Elias.
Lifted
he's roping
the
to, right.
To right. Young.
Young will make the play.
That's
the second out on two pitches. Yankees fans growing frustrated here.
Well, Ramirez digs in with his team still looking at a zero in the hit column.
Yeah, they just haven't been able to figure it out yet, but it's still early. We're seeing some pretty good pitching so far in this game.
Hit hard down the line toward the coaching box. It's a foul ball.
0-1. Up high.
Now a fastball here, not close, and it's 1-1 now. Grounder down the line at third. Backhanded.
I've Sandoval,
the
and the inning is over.
Gets him and the side is
Arias is perfect through four.
So the Yanks
Red Sox
go
still
one,
hold
two,
their
three. They trail it here, 3-0. Mookie Betts
lead it off.
Heads for the box to start off the fifth in this one.
Center first pitch from Pineda.
Mookie Betts. Liner
line.
Towards second.
The second. Kipnis gloves it. That's the first.
And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away.
Now batting. Here's Shaw. He's
Travis one Shaw. Digs in. He was sat down on strikes in his last at
first
bat.
Pitch.
Lays
what?
Off 1-0.
And that's getting bailed.
1-0
out
should
play.
Be 0-1.
Hit well on
got
the
first. Burns. That's through for a base.
And a backhanded reach at first, but he can't flag it down.
So here's Santana.
Standing in, Carlos Santana. As the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed
here. Not a lot of ground ball pitches, so he's looking for a strike.
And a cut fastball in there for a strike. It's 0-1.
Just a bit
late, he's fallen behind 0-2.
Pitch.
And here's a ball hit in the air.
Base hit into left.
In there, a base hit.
So with one out, you got men on first and second.
Dustin Pedroia will stand in now. He's struck out and flied out.
Hit runs
up. Thus far.
It's outside.
He swung out and missed.
And he's
going to
be gunned out at third. He's
there in plenty of
second
time.
Out.
He's out trying to steal third as they get the lead runner here. Pineda pauses.
0-1 to Pedroia.
Here's the 0-1. Now
line.
A liner
gloved by Belanger and
the
inning is over. Almost trouble, but great defense by the Yanks.
The inning is over.
Other
Red
than the
Sox
error, of course,
one,
that started this whole thing,
gets
to the bottom of the fifth.
Bird,
Sanchez, and Castro, 4-5-6. Yankees
Greg
looking
Bird
for their first base.
Stand in to start things it's out Greg here Bird. In the home half of the fifth. And you get the sense, Steve, that this crowd's been pretty well taken out of the ballgame to this point.
Bird. Yeah, they pretty much had to sit on their hands all afternoon.
And the shallow left.
So
another
far.
Easy fly, and
that's
the first out.
To that man out there on the mound.
Very quickly.
He's cut right through this lineup for the first
one. Went out here, Sanchez, who's 0-4.
Gary Sanchez. At the plate now, flied out in his first at bat.
Well, at least he was able
first
to
pitch.
Get it into the outfield, and that's
oh,
more than
out.
Most of his teammates can say so far.
And he misses inside with that one. Ball one.
1-0.
And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
And he didn't even have to think twice about that one. And now he's got a good hitter's count here.
2-0.
Left side.
Grounded to third. Sandoval will make the place
the
for the second out.
Very quickly, two are gone in the home
Jeez.
Fifth. Still a little early to start talking about
these
the things.
Yankees,
there
Gaspers.
You go, right there. A big goose egg in that hit column, worth keeping in mind as we get later into the afternoon.
First pitch to Castro.
Swing and a
little
oh, my
gosh. We're going to go down one,
Betts
two, three once again.
Over.
Yankees offense struggling.
That'll retire the
only scored one run in our last game.
One, two, three, go.
Something isn't working. You're swired over 2-2
games. We'll stand in as he'll lead things off for the Red Sox in their half of the sixth. Cut fastball taken for strike one.
And you can see him trying to be a little bit more patient here. He's got two strikeouts already.
Oh, my gosh.
But he's got to be careful not to fall too far behind.
Boy, the 1-1.
He couldn't pull that one back
as he
clearly broke the plane to the plate.
We've gotten so many strikeouts on the slider tonight.
Heading out towards
the right. Gardner
will
make the play.
Moves over. One out.
For Sandoval.
Pablo Sandoval steps in and perhaps looking to drive another one out of the park just like he did in the second.
Fell off 0-1.
Good swing. Just got to try and straighten that one out. Here's the 0-1.
And the pitch.
A little bouncer.
Swinging bunt down the third baseline. Sanchez in.
Strike two.
And the 0-2.
Hit hard on the ground.
Down to second. Kipnis will
throw
make
on
the play
first is in time to get Sandoval, and there are two gone now.
The right fielder, number 30.
Chris Young with a single.
Chris Young will stand in. The strikeout victim his first time, and then a base hit last time around. And here's a fastball called for strike one.
The 0-1.
That's over, but low. It's a ball and a strike.
1-1 pitch.
Tap fouled at home plate. Ready to deliver the 1-2.
And the pitch.
Ball two.
Going outside 2-2. 2-2, two outs in the sixth, and he strikes him out.
And that's the final out of the inning.
Another strikeout for Pineda. I believe that is 10.
Red Sox go down 1-2-3. They lead it.
The inning, finally a 1-2-3 inning. Yankees search for their first hit in the bottom of the sixth, down 3-0. Leading
Charlie
off Blackman 700 Black.
Start things out for the Yankees here in their half of the sixth. And now Boston's bullpen springs into action. A left-hander and a right-hander begin to throw. And this one's nowhere close as it bounces to the plate for ball one. Not too many strikeouts on the ledger for him so far, but it hasn't really mattered.
Yeah, I think ideally you'd like to see him miss a few more bats, but
he knew it was a strike.
As long as you're keeping guys off balance and you're letting your defense help you, you don't need to strike a ton of guys out to be successful.
Hit out towards second. Pedroia has it.
Pedroia will almost buy a shot first, but that's the first out.
Up next for the
Cervelli, who's
Francisco Cervelli stands in. He's
0-for-1
after grounding out. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. And now he'll try a bunt to break up the no-no.
As a first hit.
And he'll beat the throw as
that
he's
is
got
our
himself
first
a bunt single.
Hits. A bunt on the third baseline for Cervelli.
Billy Belanger,
Belanger
will
0-for-1.
And Steve, with the no-hitter gone now, he's got to remind himself
no-hitter
he's still got
game
work to do
gone
out there.
For Elias to see how that affects
sure
him.
Does. This game is not over by any means. You've got to take any no-hitter thoughts. And
it gets by Sandoval. That wasn't a really good bunt. But it one hop past Sandoval third. Here's Gardner. He's 0-for-2 on the day.
Will stand in, and he, like so
see
many others,
get another bunt down. Oh, my goodness.
So far.
Well, we've been talking about it a lot, but this
first
offense
pitch
is just getting shut down right
okay,
now.
That was a bad
we've
one.
Seen
now
some
we're try
really
it.
Fantastic
we're
pitching
it.
In this one.
I think it's best that we try and get a base hit here with Gardner.
On its way, the 0-1 pitch.
Up the middle, a base hit. That should score a run. He's coming home. There might be a play at the plate. No, there won't. Oh, yep. There was a play at the plate. But he's safe. And the Yankees will cut into that Red Sox lead. It's now 3-1. An RBI base hit for Gardner. Belanger will head into third. Here is Kipnis with runners in the corners, one out.
Stand in again.
He has
to
go ahead and run.
Each of his first two plate appearances thus far.
Yeah, and he just needs to
we
make
going
a small
to warm up
adjustment
the
and stay
pitch
through the middle of the ball. Think about hitting the line driver right
that
back
one's up high. 1-0.
Ball one. You know, some of Jason Kipnis' teammates affectionately call him Dirtbag because he has a habit of giving his body up and getting his uniform dirty on every play. And you got to love a guy like that.
Swing and he pops him up. Over toward foul territory.
Technically, we could bunt and probably score out, but I am not taking that risk right now.
All the bases Kipnis is capable of stealing, it's no surprise why his uniform is so dirty all the time. He stole more than 30 in 2012 and 13, 22 bags in 2014.
Yeah, and not quite as many steals in 2015, but his overall production was still pretty great, especially for a second baseman.
Another one sent foul. One run on three
hits. The 50th pitch for
one
Elias.
Error on the Yankee line score so far.
Okay, geez.
Still 1-2 as
not
he fouls it away.
Swing out, but at least I fouled it off. Kipnis is 0 for 2 today, 2 flyouts. On deck sitting is Hanley Ramirez.
Has to be thinking pitch. Strikeout here.
Outside 2-2.
And
two
he
two.
Lays off a pitch outside as they draw
even
at 2-2.
Two two. So far.
Ooh,
well,
there's a tough
the
one
Yankees
to take
well.
Right there on a 1-2 pitch. Especially
they can all start against a couple of bunts.
So
outside,
that.
The count runs full
outside
with Hanley on deck.
Full count, 3-2.
The payoff pitch.
Ready with the payoff pitch.
Up the middle, it's a base hit for Kipnis, and that'll bring the Yankees within one.
An
RBI single up the middle.
The
thing's starting to get out of hand for Elias. You know, they're going
to
take him out.
No,
they won't. Here's Hanley. He's 0 for 2-2 ground out. The third ground out would be very big.
As he'll look to bring home that tying run
from
second with a base hit into the outfield.
The game's tying run is on second base.
And
that misses ball
inside 1-0.
The go-ahead runs
so
the first, too.
After the strong five
Yankees
innings, things have not come as easily for him here in inning number six.
This is the first inning. Yankees got a base runner. They have also
lineup.
Scored two
they
runs. That's outside 2-0.
And
Greg Bird will wait on deck.
Better counts to hit. And
but I would probably pinch
off.
Hit Soler. But want the 2-0.
Off
the swinging bunt. It's a fair ball. They go to second.
But
they'll get one.
They
so men on the corners
get,
two outs.
And the inning will continue.
So here's Bird.
So
he's going to be pinch hit four. We're going to start. We're going to hit Soler.
With that equalizing run just 90
so men on the corners. Two outs.
Jorge
Soler. Out of the game with a base hit.
See what he can do
take
off
the lead
bench
one
the
gap.
He'll bat with runners at the corners.
Here is
Jorge
Soler.
Here.
First pitch. Outside for ball
he
one.
Try and get him out in front to start the at bat.
On deck waiting is Gary Sanchez. One.
That misses.
Outside.
2-0. Runners at
here's
the corners.
Count.
Two men out.
Trout off 2-1.
Right
this will be the 60th pitch.
Strike one.
This is like 25 pitches on the inning.
Trying to hold the lead.
Trout off 2-2.
Right
this
plate.
Is a huge spot here for Jorge Soler. 2-2. Fouled off. He's keeping that changeup low.
Right at home plate.
Oh, okay,
good
D, guys.
On a tough pitch,
I meant to
and
hang
he'll
off,
stick around
at least,
to see another one.
At the very
already
least, I fouled it off.
Pitches
remain
to this
two.
Point in the inning.
Ground
ball
at the third.
Side.
Sandoval will make the play, and the inning is over.
For the
but
out
the Yankees score two.
So it's two runs on four base
four
hits,
hits,
no errors, and a couple of
and
men
the
left
perfect game.
On.
That is the seventh.
We're
Red Sox lead up by just one now.
Oh, we're going to
Soler will not
the ball
play
game
first.
As he'll take over
Jackie
at first
Bradley
base.
Lead it off.
Jackie Bradley Jr. is set to get us started for the late innings of this one.
We're going to play Ackley at first base.
Dustin Ackley is going to come on as a defensive replacement.
So, Pineda has 9 pitches. He'll pitch to start off the 7th.
Starts him with a good rising
fastball
there for strike 1.
The 0-1.
That's in there. And he's deep in the hole now, 0-2.
The chances is short on rest, but I plan to pitch Miller and Chapman. This is a close game, the 0-2.
Now here's a ball hit in the air to straightaway right field.
Yeah,
this ball's got
young.
Plenty of carry to it, and it is
I don't understand.
Out of here.
He just left the slider right over the plate. Bradley's second home run of the game. And we'll bring in
a
new Ramirez.
A solo shot here to straightaway right field.
That's it for Pineda.
His
four
second of the game.
Runs. 18
and
games for Ramirez.
3-1
record with one save for
2 lead.
30 in the third inning, pitched 28 strikeouts.
Come on
279
now,
average
take over
pretty high,
inning
but only
number 7
against Rays. Wait, I don't know what my pitch is.
Steven
Hudson
will be the first one to greet him
pitch.
As he'll start fresh here with the bases empty
and
following the home run. And he gets ahead here with the fastball. Strike
one.
And here's a curveball in the dirt that time for a ball. 1-1. Now a swing and a miss, and he's behind 1-2. A ball flying around the yard in this one,
here's
as you
one,
see
two.
So far there.
Low.
A little low. It's 2-2.
And the pitch.
Ball three.
Outside, count runs low. That's on deck.
He knows a drill.
Payoff pitch. Ground to first. Nice play.
By
Ackley.
Not giving up walks at this stage of the game because those
Could be fatal.
One out of your bets is one for three.
Mookie Betts digs in with one run in and one gone in the inning. And a called strike down in the zone. Nothing in one.
Not
a bad idea to take.
Hold that thought.
There goes a two runs you got back.
Down the line in left, hooking, but it's a fair
ball. I hate that so much. Absolutely so much. Once we are offensive, cut it to one.
In left, home run number two solo five homers on the year. And just like that, it's now a 5-2 ball
game.
And
that basically gets it out of reach. Fifth home run of the year for Betts.
Yeah, and this is just a fastball right here, but I'm pretty sure it's not where he wanted it. This has got some elevation to it, and that's one of those where you know it's going to be a home run as soon as you let go of it.
Travis Shaw will stand in now following the home run, and you wonder if that losing streak is about to go by the wayside.
Well, they're not home yet, but certainly this has been a much better performance than we've seen out of them for a while now. So all sides seem to be pointing to a potential victory.
Well, breaking ball, yeah, he's not looking like so far they're going to get this sweep here against the Sox. Need to come back.
Carlos Santana started to go around, but it's a called strike.
0-1.
Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2.
And 1-2.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike 3.
Not really good inning. Gave up two home runs. There goes the two runs we got back last inning.
Two runs come across here.
That was kind of a
waste.
Carson set the warm up in the Sox bullpen, and we are going to warm up.
Gary Sanchez.
Actually,
we'll
want to
try again.
Actually, want to try out with a fly out and a ground ball this far.
Well, guys, if you split the difference between the fly ball and the grounder put in play, you've got a nice line drive. So maybe we'll witness that right here.
Swing and bunt
weakly near the plate.
Gary Sanchez has to start the season.
The wind up and the 0-1. Here's a line drive out to left
into left to face
it.
It's a hot start. Sanchez will continue. Lead off base hit. That's pretty big if we're trying to come back. Here's Castro.
Ready once again. Starlin Castro. He flew out in his last at bat. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. And on one pitch, he's retired.
So, one out. Gary's on first, stepping in. Is Charlie
Blackman will dig in for a third time now. He's popped out and grounded out so far.
I would bump, but I want to play for the beginning. So we're going to drive up your base hit. In the dirt.
In the dirt
I
here.
I went back.
Fortunately, here, no advance.
The 0-1.
And a good idea to hold off on that swing.
Didn't go
it's ball one.
You know, sometimes when you're thinking fastball, you try to get moving just a little bit early. And that's a good job of recognizing off-speed and then holding back on the swing.
And a half-hearted attempt that time as he broke the plane of the plate. It's a ball and two strikes now. And a swing and a miss as they caught him reaching that time.
You're old, and I really should trade you because you don't fit with this team.
Francisco Cervelli.
Here's Cervelli. He got the first hit of the game for the Yankees on this field plus thing.
Cervelli! First pitch on its way. Gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. High in the air.
Deep center field.
Well out to deep center.
Throwing back Betts.
Back goes Betts.
Are you kidding me?
And that ends the inning.
Every
one
time.
One left for the Yankees.
We're down by three runs.
Dustin
not looking
Pedroia
like we're going to get the win here today.
In. One of the few guys not to join the hit
keep
parade
you out there
so far.
For one pitch.
Line
that's one out.
Center field. Blackman patrolling center makes the play. One out.
Fans not happy with their performance today. They really wanted a sweep against Boston.
Really
now it's going to take
here, 0 for 3 in
basically
the game
American.
So far.
Swarzak
Anthony Swarzak
extremely impressive so far this year.
Appearance in this campaign.
First pitch.
Swing and a liner. Foul. Five runs, 11 hits. And no errors for the Red Sox to this
and
point.
And the 0-1. Foul off of 2.
Swing and a line drive. But foul. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Chop foul at the plate. And he stays alive. Still 0-2.
Pitch.
Struck him out as his woes continue as that's his third strikeout of the game.
Here, Sandoval still looks shot.
Pablo Sandoval in the game steps game. In and perhaps looking to drive another first one pitch. Out of the park, just like he did in the second. That ball's headed for the gap in left center.
Off,
he's
off,
got a base
off.
Hit.
Throw
possibly
it, throw it.
More. Throw into second.
Into second. It's going to be a tough play.
And he's able
and he's
to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit.
So here will be Chris Young.
Chris Young will get an opportunity here in a run-scoring spot now first following
pitch.
The two-out double.
And
they set the
one.
Target in, and this finds the inside corner for strike one. Well, you see there on the graphic, he's at second with his fourth double here on the season. Swung
the
on and chopped up the middle.
Kipnis,
and
got
nothing
him.
Will come
that's
with a two-out
out.
Double as the inning is
and
over.
The bottom of the eighth.
Danger averted following the two-out double. We're back with more on it. Billy Belanger.
Belanger
will
lead off. He's
going to start
the single.
Out
Craig
there.
Half Kimberly,
of the eighth with that starter
warm.
Still
bullpen.
Out there, and he's definitely
We're
been
up
a tough nut to crack.
No, he's been dominant
we,
all game
close
long.
This game up.
I think
to
part
one
of it
two.
Is that he got himself
if
a nice
the game up to one,
lead
we'll bring
early
in
on.
Else.
That's
one pitch.
Allowed him to not
one out
really
for Belanger
about making a mistake. It's been free and easy the whole way through.
Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Third baseman in tight, protecting the bunt, the first pitch. Behind on that one, now behind in the count, 0-1.
B-0-1.
And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two.
Bro. B-0-2.
He takes strike three called on the fastball.
Right.
Couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Here's Kipnis. He's one for three, then RBI single.
And in now with two away, needing to really get something started here.
And their chances of getting back into
pitch.
This ballgame are growing dimmer by the bat.
The middle, that's
Kipnis.
Drilled
right back up the middle, and that's through for a hit.
Here's Hanley. He can really use a two-out base hit here.
Hanley Ramirez will stand in for the fourth time now, still looking for his first hit of the ballgame.
And he's not the only one either. This has been a great pitching performance so far, and they've had these guys chasing their tails all
off.
Game long.
Did not see a slide step. We're going to try and snag this base with Kipnis. 0-1.
The 0-1
there
pitch.
He goes.
He's running towards
pitches
second.
A called strike, and he's safe
strike.
At second
the
on
throw.
The base.
Way late, and he's in there easily
running
at
scoring
second.
Position now for Hanley to count as 0-2. 80th pitch
the
for Ryan.
0-2 delivery. Swing, and
oh,
the miss
are
got
you
him
kidding
reaching.
Me?
The throw to first is in time.
Well,
and
the over.
The inning is
swung
over.
On. Apparently, I swung. Apparently.
Yanks leave one.
Yep.
They trail.
MLB sometimes.
Jackie Bradley Jr.
J.B. Dale lead it off. He got two home runs already.
Take you back to inning number seven. This was his second home run of the ball game, as he'd like nothing more than to make it three right here. Vinny Pastano.
Two dingers for Black.
Start the ninth inning as he looks to keep this deficit right where it is.
Two dingers
for
J.B.J. already. Jackie Bradley Jr.
And
they just all got a call.
Miss 1-1.
And 1-1.
And he'll take a look at a strike on the inside corner. It's 1-2.
Sit down.
Hard hit ball to second.
Kipnis
has it. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway.
Here's Steven Hudson. He's over
Steven Hudson will step in. A ground out victim as last time. And he'll
try
to crowd him there to start the at bat. It's 1-0.
1-0.
And he takes a called strike one.
Right back inside with a fastball. This time, he got the call.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
A 2-1. Oh,
that's
going to
even up the count at 2-2.
2-2 count, one out here, and that's
slurve. Doesn't get the call, and it's full now. 3-2.
Well,
count pitch to Hudson.
Count full now. It's a nice job of laying off on that one, although it kind of looked like an easy one to take.
And he'll strike out here yet again, as it's been a ballgame to forget thus far. Four strikeouts.
Here's the best.
Will stand in to try it again already with first one
pitch.
Home run of the ball game and
what?
Two. There it was back in the
literally
100%
of that baseball was
that
inside the strike zone
for these guys.
1-1.
Nobody on. Hit hard to the right.
Bowed down
foul.
On one, two. Pitches fall off.
Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Out another in front foul. Of that one. May have been looking fastball. Good job just to make contact.
1-2.
Oh, he goes
Popping
up the
shallow,
ladder on the fastball
Belanger.
And pops this one up.
Under it. And
Belanger.
The Red Sox go down
1-2-3.
Yankees
retired.
Only three in their last ups. They're down 5-2.
Down. Craig Kimbrell is on now to try Kimbrell to close
pitches,
things down here in the ninth.
This year, including 1.4 ERA.
Leading off the inning.
Dustin Ackley will lead it off. And just
to get
in case
something
Jackson
going here
and
even this game up.
Well, it's a close ball game, but it's starting to get late. So they need to get at least one back here in this
first pitch
inning.
To Ackley.
And this is in the air
and
down the
shallow
left
going
foul.
Foul
territory.
But the play is made.
Is
that's
there to
first
make the catch, and it's a dreadful start to the bottom of the ninth. One pitch, one out.
League leader
so
saves.
Man
gone
to start
up there with
the top
14.
Of the ninth.
Chapman
as
also.
We take a look at league saves leaders.
Here's Gary Sanchez.
Play. And as you see, he's right up there among league leaders in that department. Kimbrell pauses. First pitch on its way. Skied into straightaway right.
Under right.
Young
going back,
there.
Chris Young, and two pitches, two
and
outs.
That's the
start
second
off the ninth.
Out of the inning.
Last chance, he'll go to Starlin Castro. The Yankees down three.
Starlin Castro makes his way to the plate, needing to make something happen. They're down to their final out in the ninth inning.
That's not looking too good for him anymore, but you know what? There's no clock in this sport.
Foul off.
That's
today, really,
reason.
The pitching has struggled a lot, especially with Michael Pineda, but the deep hitting really didn't pick him up. Like last game, hitting was struggling a lot. We only scored one run, but you picked us up.
The 0-1
put up a
delivery.
0-9.
And now a curveball that bounces
outside
up to the
there,
plate.
One
it's
more.
1-1.
Thank you for joining here in the ninth. Two outs. You're kind of late. Game almost ending.
And
inside
a knuckle
here.
Missed that time. 2-1. One.
The 2-1.
Can't find his own there, and it's 3-1.
Well, this is a good job to work the count from 0-1 to 3-1, and now he's really in the driver's seat to see a fastball.
And this one misses for
ball four.
And the Yankees get a base runner here with two away.
Here's Blackman with a tying run.
Charlie Blackman
sitting on
deck. Dig in now, hoping to perhaps make him pay for the two-out walk.
Yeah, nothing going on earlier in this inning, but a chance to make some noise right here. Those kind of
and shallow left.
Ranging
carrying
back
is Bradley and
the
Red Sox win.
That's the ball game.
They'll salvage
more great work
1-3
here
in the series against the Yankees
the
as they fail
to fire a scoreless ninth speed. Inning and pick up the save. His
rough start for
nasty.
Pineda today. And really the Yankees offense only came to life in one inning. Elias, the pretty decent game, 8 innings, pitched 6 hits, 2 runs, 2 earned, no walks, 4 Ks. He was perfect through 5, but struggled in the 6th. Really, 2 runs, 7 for the Sox. Really would put this game away. The Yankees were close on making a comeback.
Well,
quite,
the bats were
off.
Certainly working in this one, but
play
out
the game
of
everybody, for the Sox
I'd
is
say
down,
this
undoubtedly
man most Jackie, deserves to
Bradley
be our
Jr.
top
had 2 home runs and a double
game.
Today's game.
Yeah, he connected on a
two
couple
RBIs.
Of long home runs. Really put his guys on his back and carried him to the victory.
So that's a wrap.
Red Sox
here
win it with 5 runs, 12 hits, no errors.
The
Yankees 2 runs, 6 hits, 1
error. You've been watching MLB The Show.
And ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching this edition of MLB 16 Yankees Franchise Mode. We were unable to get the win today, as our record falls to 22-27. We'll have a 3-game stand up against the Tigers. Then we'll play 3 on the road against 4 on the road against City and 3 on the road to San Francisco. As we'll start a road stand coming up. I mean, if you guys want, I probably won't play in Detroit or Kansas City. But if you guys want to see a game at San Francisco, that'd be pretty cool. So let me know. Otherwise, we would probably see if Chris Sale gets to start back in Chicago. And then maybe home against Baltimore would be nice. See a game that, of course, we'll play. Probably one at Baltimore before the... Yeah, we'll probably play this game right here before the All-Star break in 2017. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, check out Dan the Yankees Fan. Like the video and subscribe. Peace out.